السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، ولا إله إلا الله إلهنا وإله الأولين والآخرين وقيوم السماوات والأرض، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله تبارك وتعالى رحمة للعالمين وإماما للمتقين وحجة علينا نحن الخلائق أجمعين، فأخرجنا به من ظلمات الكفر إلى نور الإيمان بالله رب العالمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، إخوة الإسلام، اليوم في الوقت المخصص لنا للخطبة أريد أن يعني أشارك مع حضراتكم خبرة مرت علي من خلال عملي، ويعني ردود الأفعال من بعض المسلمين تجاه هذا الأمر مختلفة تماما، وكلما أيقنا وأمنا بها أتت ثمارها، وكلما يعني تجاهلناها لم تؤت أي ثمار، لأننا لا نقوم بها بقلوبنا. يأتيك وأنت تعمل كإمام، يأتيك إنسان بمشكلة نفسية، بدنية، اجتماعية، عائلية تصف له القرآن. يا أخي قم بذلك. يعني اليوم أنا لا أنافس أحداً بالمناسبة، وليس عندي وقت لأن أستقبل كل الناس بهمومهم ومشاكلهم، ولكن أريد أن أؤكد على هذا الأمر لعلنا جميعاً يعني نسترجع ونؤكد على ما نعلمه. كلنا يعلم أن الله تبارك وتعالى قال أن القرآن فيه شفاء للناس. أنت تعلم ذلك، أنا أعلم علم اليقين أنك وأنا نعلم ذلك، ولكن لا نطبق. يأتيك إنسان، يعني حدثت كثيرا، يا أخي أنا أعاني من هذا الأمر، ذهبت إلى الأطباء ولم يعني ليس هناك نتيجة، كما أنا عندي نفس المشكلة. يا أخي خلاص استعن بالله عز وجل، يعني ضع ذلك في قلبك واقرأ القرآن على نفسك من قلبك بعلمك وبيقينك بأن الله شافيك. الناس عند هذه الحالة صنفان. الصنف الأول هو يأتيك لأنه فقد الأمل في غيره، هو لم يذهب إلى الله قبل أن يذهب إلى أي إنسان، يأتيك لأنه فقد الأمل في غيره، خلاص هنروح، ويعتقد بأنك كرجل دين معك هذه الآلة السحرية التي من خلالها تضع يدك على جبهته ثم يشفى. لا تقوم بذلك لأنك لست كما يعتقد، وتصف له الدواء الذي وصفه رب العالمين سبحانه وتعالى فلا يكتلف، لم يأخذ ما جاء من أجله فيذهب، لن ينفعه شيء. والآخر جاءك بيقين بأنك ربما عندك ما يعينه وما يشفيه بإذن الله تعالى، فيأخذ ذلك بانبهار وبإدراك وبيقين، ثم يقرأه على نفسه، ثم يأتيك بعد أيام قلائل وحدثت كثيرا ويقول بالفعل أتت ثمارها. لست أو ليست بسبب أنك إمام ماهر أو أن كل يعلم الرقية، أو أنه إنسان حتى يعني وصل إلى درجة عالية من اليقين أو من الإيمان، بل لأنه أيقن بأن ذلك شفاء. So my dear brothers and listening sisters, today I'm going to share this experience with you very quick. Sometimes when you work as an imam, and that's why I have the khatib training, and I need to get as many as I can of the help and the support from the brothers and the youth of the community who've been struggling for 4 years. If the imam in any masjid, I'm not talking about the MCE, wants to يعني, go out, like he's traveling, for example, it's a real struggle to have somebody reliable to give a khutbah. I don't know why. It's not a big deal at the end of the day. Whatever. We'll talk about this later. But when you work that job, you get these concerns from the community, and it's your job to address these concerns. Brother comes to you, I can't sleep. Why, akhi? You know what? I see things happening around me. I'm not advertising for this, by the way, but it happens. What do you see? I see things. And I went to the psychiatrist, the psychologist, it didn't work. Okay, hold on. Let's go through the remedy and the cure and the healing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us. Brother, do you pray? No, on and off. Do you do the adhkar before you go to bed? No, I don't know them either. Okay, خلاص. To me, now as a doctor, يعني with due respect to all brothers, the doctor over here, you know what to describe or prescribe at this moment. خلاص, the Quran is there. Take it. And another brother comes, you know what? I'm sure that there is nothing physical with me. It's just a, I don't know what's going on. خلاص, the Quran is there. Another one, you know, my child doesn't go to bed and doesn't sleep and cried all the time. Have you tried? And I'm asking everybody here, have you ever tried when your child cries to go and to read the Quran for him or on him? Have you tried that? I don't know that. I take him to the Sheikh. Akhi, why? I'll explain this at the end of the khutbah too. Okay? Then you give him that prescription. Two people, or the people are two types now. The first one, Yakhi, I'm coming to get a solution. You're giving me Quran to read. I can't read even. Yakhi, I'm giving you what you have to do. You know, okay, khalas. You know, he calls his wife. This guy is like, he doesn't know what to do. He's just giving me some ayat to read. I don't know, I was waiting for something physical to get from him. Khalas, didn't work. The other one gets it and goes and says, you know what? Yes, I have a problem. It's my own problem. It's my own issue. I don't pray. I don't read Quran. I don't do my adhkar. So I'm going to start doing that right away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the shifa. Not you, not the sheikh, not the doctor. It's him subhanahu wa ta'ala. لماذا نصف ذلك؟ لماذا نعتقد بذلك؟ لماذا نؤمن بذلك؟ Why we as Muslims believe that this Quran is shifa? Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, states that clearly in the Quran, by the way. And when you go and read about the meaning or the tafsir of the ayat, you will be really surprised, as you will be today, inshallah ta'ala. أولاً الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين. Number one, الله سبحانه وتعالى says in سورة الإسراء, we send down from of the Quran that which is a healing and a mercy for the believers. By the way, he said the believers. For somebody who believes in that, who reads the ayat with this belief, as he will get it inshallah ta'ala today. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in Surah Fussilat, قُلْ هُوَ هُدًى وَشِفَاءٌ يعني وَلَوْ جَعَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنَ عَجَمِيًا لَقَالُوا لَوْلَا فُصِّلَتْ آيَاتُ وَعَجَمِيٌ وَعَرَبِيٌ قُلْ هُوَ. This Quran is a guidance and healing and cure for the believers again. والعلماء يقولون أن القرآن شفاء لثلاثة أنواع من الأمراض. The Quran is a cure. The Quran that you have. The Quran that you abandon. The Quran that you never read. The Quran that you don't listen to. The Quran that you go to bed every single, your bed every single night, and you never ever remember to read Surah Ayatul Kursi, for example, or Al-Mu'awidat, or Al-Fatiha. Don't care about that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it is real shifa for, number one, the أمراض وأدواء الشهوات والشبهات. Brother, and this is to me, wallahi, I'm saying to myself, not before I say to everybody else. If you have a problem with your desires, your shahwa, you attach big time to the lust, to the desires, to the dunya, to the house, to the car, to the wife, to the kids, to the girls, to the money, to everything like everybody else, check your connection with the Quran. You didn't see the Quran since last Ramadan. I'm telling you, I'm answering on your behalf. Your connection with the Quran, the relationship between you and the Quran got disconnected since last Ramadan. We're in Rajab, by the way. We're almost there. Ramadan is knocking the door. Okay? ولذلك الله تبارك وتعالى يقول في سورة الإسراء أيضا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوى. Indeed, this Quran guides to the best way. Guides you if you believe in that. Number one. الأمر الثاني كما يقول إمام القيم رحمه الله ما من دائم جسدي إلا وفي القرآن دواؤه علمه من علمه وجهله من جهله. Again, it's your problem. It's your issue. You don't get it. You don't understand it. We do not understand it. Imam Qayyim said that there is no any type of disease, but you have a remedy, a cure for it in the Quran. Some people, they know that. Some other, they miss it. They don't get it. Listen to this. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu,
يأتيه رجل أصابه الرعاف أمدا طويلا، فيأتي فيكتب بيده على جبهته بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم من سورة هود، وقيل يا أرض ابلعي ماءك ويا سماء أقلعي وغيض الماء وقضي الأمر فيشفى الرجل على الفور. So number two, that the Quran is a remedy. I'm not saying don't go to your doctor again, because my friends here, the doctors, don't misunderstand what I'm saying. They will go to you. They will get my message. Then when they have a stomach ache, they will run away to your office or toothache, whatever it is. Yeah. So number two, it is a cure, a medication for your physical problems. How is it? Listen. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Abbas, a man came to him, he's been suffering from ru'af, nose bleed, for a long time. He came to Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, then he wrote on his forehead this ayah from Surah Hud, which means, the ayah means, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it was said, O earth, swallow your water. It's ru'af, right? Look how they connect things. How they connect the meaning of the ayat to the reality. وَقِيلَ يَا أَرْضُ بْلَعِي مَاءَكِ O earth, swallow your water. وَيَا سَمَاءُ أَقْلِعِي O sky, withhold your water. Stop. He means that. وَقِيضَ الْمَاءَ Stop. The water stop. وَقُوضِيَ الْأَمْرُ The matter was accomplished. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in a different context. Then he take it, he understand the meaning, he wants apply the same meaning on that. But again, you might say, you know what, ya Sheikh, this is Abdullah ibn Abbas. You're talking about, khalas, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talked about fiqh of Abdullah ibn Abbas. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua to Abdullah ibn Abbas. How come I do like him? Listen, it came in Sahih Bukhari. جاء في صحيح البخاري حديثا صحيح عن سيدنا أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه. يقول خرج نفر من أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فمروا على حي من أحياء العرب فلم يقروهم، كانوا بخلا معاهم شوي، فلم يقروهم فجلسوا حتى جاءهم رجل يخبرهم بأن رئيس أو زعيم أو يعني زعيم هذا الحي قد لدغ، قالوا عقرب ولده، فهل منكم أو هل معكم من دواء أو منكم من راق؟ فخرج رجل من بينهم، حتى لم يذكر اسمه في الحديث، فخرج رجل من بينهم من بين صحابة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال لهم نرقيه على أن تجعلوا لنا جحنا، قد كنتم بخلاء معنا، فقالوا لهم لكم هذا يعني الجعل من الماشية، هذا العدد من الماشية، فذهب وقرأ عليه سورة الفاتحة فشفي الرجل. فقال الصحابة له والله لنأخذ من ذلك شيئا حتى نأتي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني احنا we're not sure ان احنا we got a nice email. Somebody is doubting the fact that you know why the Islamic organizations and the Muslim scholars they charge on teaching the Islam. But خلاص, let them stay in the street. They teach you Islam and they go in the street, ask for money. يعني, what are you guys coming from? يعني, okay, they give them that. They got the reward. They got the edge. They got, and who approved that? Who approved that for them? When they went to Prophet ﷺ, he smiled. And he told them, and I left English. لما دعوا إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ضحك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال له من أدراك بأنها رقية؟ من العرفة؟ يا أخي هو قرأ وننزله من القرآن ما هو شفاء؟ That's it. So again, a group of صحابة as came in the authentic hadith on the authority of سيدنا أبو سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه. They went out for something. They passed by a neighborhood. Let's say neighborhood. Asked for food, they didn't give him anything. We don't have food for you. What happened that area, the master of that tribe got stung by a scorpion. Then they went to them, you know, we need help now. You know, do you guys have any medication or some type of ruqya that you can read on him. They said, you know, one of the Sahaba said that if I do that, you're going to give us the reward. We'll give you everything. Now they need them. Okay. So he went and he read Surah Al-Fatiha that you and I will read at least 17 times a day. At least. If you don't pray Sunnah every day, you read Al-Fatiha 17 times. And you still have the stomach ache and the headache and the migraine. And you have the knee problem and the whatever problem. And you have the psychological problems that you have. And I have the same. I'm not blaming anybody. I'm starting with myself again. Because we don't have this yaqeen in our heart that it is ruqya. It is shifa. It is cure. It's healing for your problems and your even physical problems. So he read Surah Al-Fatiha, then they got what they got, what they gave them. Then the Sahaba, they said that we're not accepting that until we ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He smiled sallallahu alaihi wasallam to them and he told them, take it and give me my share. And he smiled and asked him, how did you know that it's Al-Fatiha, it's a cure, it's a shifa? Yani, and there is no answer came from the Sahabi because you and I have to know that the answer in the Quran is clear. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Number two. الأمر الثالث في وده بقى يعني أكثرها إثارة. يعني ده بيجي لك واحد يقول لك يا أخي أنا الجن عايش معايا في البيت. طب يعني هو الجن يا سيدي الدنيا كلها عايش معاك أنت؟ ولا يا أخي بقى لي 50 سنة ما مش عارف أعمل يا أخي؟ وتيجي الأخت تقول لك والله البيت بيتحرك. ويجي واحد يقول لك سجادة الصلاة وقفت. ويجي واحد يقول لك ابني مش عارف إيه وابني ما بيخرجش من الأوضة. طب ما أنت رميته طول عمره قدام الأيباد whatever laptop or whatever, and then you get him connected to something and then you come and complain. Number three of the problems that we have that the Quran for sure 100% I'm telling you 100% it's a cure for it. It's the psychological problems that you and I have, the sihr, the evil eye that you get. وفي سحر يا شيخ يا أخي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول في حديث صحيح أكثر من يموت من أمتي بعد قضاء الله وقدره من العين. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the authentic hadith that most of the death in my ummah after for sure that's the destiny of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. يعني don't come and say that he gave me an evil eye and he killed me. No. But if you killed, you're not going to say anything. But somebody will say that he killed him. Whatever it is. But the Prophet ﷺ said that the evil eye is a reason for the death of many of this ummah. Many, many people of this ummah, they die because of this. And don't say that, you know what, the whole idea of the whole khutbah came to me. I was praying Isha yesterday and I read Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in Surah Al-Kahf. وَلَوْلَا إِذْ دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ قلت ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. يا أخي we don't ever, you know, you see a nice car, ما شاء الله is not in our terminologies. We don't say بسم الله ما شاء الله. Why Allah سبحانه وتعالى says that if you go to your own place, if you buy a new car, if you your son gets like high grades remarks in school, يا أخي say ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. Protect yourself from your own eye. What about other people? What about other people when you look at them, when you want the ni'mah that Allah gave them? So I'll protect myself. So I'm saying that people come with these concerns. They say, you know what, Sheikh, you know what, we have this, we have that, it's Quran. It's not anything else, it's Quran. Because the evil eye is there, and the magician are there, the sihr is there, the katba is there, I'm telling you, it happens. But we don't deal with it except with the Quran, and you personally deal with it. Don't think that this Sheikh, and yani I have something about this too. Don't think that anybody has a magic power to help you. It's the Quran. Why? لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نفسه رقى ورقي. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did ruqya for others, and he got ruqya for himself. Jibreel alayhi salam did ruqya for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jibreel did that. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at the children of Ja'far, Nabi Talib. He looked at them, he noticed Sometimes we were not saying that we can, but sometimes we're able to يعني prescribe this or to see it. يعني somebody is like all of a sudden he's very successful in that field. Somebody gave him a bad eye, like, you know what, it's everything is distracted, he is disturbed, everything is going يعني the wrong way, something wrong. Go back to the Quran, ya akhi. Don't go to anybody. Go to the Quran. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam looked at the children of Sayyidina Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, and he ordered them to be to have ruqya, يعني to do ruqya for them. As-Sahaba, they used to do it for one another. So the medication in brief for any psychological or psychiatrist problem, you go to your doctor at the end of the day. But we're saying, you know what, take this with iman, with yaqeen, and believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the medication for you in the Quran, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained to us, and as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in his ahadith, and ask him clearly in the ayat that we mentioned. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولو الله تبارك وتعالى وأنتم موقنون. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وبعد. خلاص يعني علمنا وعرفنا بأن القرآن شفاء لكل الأمراض. هل نقع فريسة لمتصيدي أمراض الناس وضعفهم وهؤلاء ضعاف النفوس وضعاف الإيمان وضعاف العلم وضعاف اليقين الذين يستغلون هؤلاء أم لا؟ يا أخي الناس في علاجهم للقرآن أو بالقرآن ثلاثة أصناف. So people when it comes to you seek help, you want to get help for something that you have or your wife has or your kids has. يعني a brother come to me and said that my sister, whenever she's like somebody proposed to her, she's like it doesn't work. خلاص يعني I don't think it's always a jinn or magic. Somebody come, you know what, يعني شيخ, you know, man, they don't like you. خلاص you propose to the girls, they don't like you. Why don't you look at it this way? Why don't you change yourself? Why don't you think that there is something wrong with you? It's not always something else. Anyway, but let's say that you have a problem. Look at the person that you're approaching. I'm not saying approach us. But do not go to somebody who will misuse you and take advantage on you and give you a hard time and take your money. Some people are paying money from here to the Middle East to fix problems over here. Ya akhida wallahi, if he is Superman, he's not going to do it. What are you guys talking about? You know what? Sheikh, we've been paying money for years, but it didn't work. خلاص طب يا أخي. Still, the shaitan is playing with your mind. It's taking advantage on you. يقول العلماء أن من يعالج بالقرآن ثلاثة. Those who يعني help to cure with the Quran are three categories of people. Number one, الصنف الأول هذا الرجل الذي يرقي وهو يعلم الرقية. The first one is somebody who knows, who does ruqya, and he knows exactly what's ruqya. يعني simply, first, I'm telling you, this guy doesn't charge. Bottom line, if he takes your money, yeah, he can take you, can take donation to the masjid. That's something else. Because if you come to me and I ask you for donation, let's say you said no, charge. We'll charge for the masjid, not for us. Okay, number one doesn't show. Number two, he's not any way ambiguous. It's the Quran that you listen to. When you listen to the Quran, you know, Sheikh Mashari or Sheikh Minshawi or Mustafa Ismail, and when you sit and you listen to those people, that's the same Quran. It doesn't give you something hidden and keep it somewhere and do it where, and all of this hassles. It's not true. Very simple. He reads Al-Fatiha, Ayat Al-Kursi, the last few Ayat Aman Al-Rasul from Surah Al-Baqarah. He reads Al-Mu'awwidhatayn. He reads Qul Huwallahu Ahad. he comes and say from the sunnah, if it's عين, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيطان وهامة ومن كل عين لامة. It's مرض. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال كان يدعو بهذا الدعاء: اللهم رب الناس أذهب البأس، اشفي أنت الشافي لا شفاء. Nothing more than that. يا أخي sometimes I go personally, I go and I do this with some people, and you know when you feel that the person that you're talking to is not getting it, they look at you, they want to get rid of you. خلاص, you didn't do what you were here for. No, it's not this. So number one, it's very simple, somebody who knows. So don't go to anybody but this person, not this man. I'm not specifying a certain human being, but I say the person who knows what he's doing. Number two, somebody, and this is scary too, you might get a book from somebody, not because it's a book, it's authentic. Some people know, I read it in a book, but who wrote the book? From where he got it? If it is not from the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, then it's not a book. To me, it's not a book. Don't take it. So some people, they do it with jahl, with ignorance. And it's not good to do it to yourself or to anybody else if you're not aware of it. And the worst is number three. هؤلاء المشعوذين. الصنف الثالث, هؤلاء المشعوذين الذين كما قلت يستغلون ضعف الناس ويستعينون والعياذ بالله بالجن على ذلك. If somebody is telling you, you know, I know you, your mom's name is Zainab. If he is telling you that, and nobody tells him that, 100% he doesn't know the unseen, by the way. Don't think that he knows the unseen. And he can cure you from overseas. Okay, he's not this. Somebody, والعياذ بالله, you're seeking the help of the jinn. And when somebody reached that level, والعياذ بالله, they're committing an act of shirk. And they're taking your money. And some people, والعياذ بالله, they're sending their kids to them. They're sending their wives. The wife go to the sheikh, to his place, to do ruqya on her. From where we get this? Who's the sheikh who does ruqya to a sister and touch her? From where and how? How it happens? In which religion you guys, we do this? If that's the level that you didn't want, come back. Don't do it. Don't do it. This body or this person, wal'iyadu billah, is taking advantage on you. And wal'iyadu billah is committing shirk, as I said earlier. Then what should I do, ya Shaykh? I'm shy. I'm shy to go to the Shaykh and to يعني, ask him to do ruqya for me, ya akhi. Let me ask you something. دعني أسألك هذا السؤال. ابنك عنده مشكلة. زوجتك عندها مشكلة. أنت عندك مشكلة. هل تعتقد بأي حال من الأحوال أن هذا الرجل الغريب سيحبك أو يحب أبنائك أكثر مما تحب نفسك أو أبنائك؟ لا. أبداً. مستحيل. So when you think about it, if you're taking yourself or your family member to somebody to help him with the Quran, ask yourself this question. Do you think that this person loves you or your family more than you love yourself or your family? Absolutely not. Then, يقول العلماء أكمل الرقية أن يرقي الإنسان نفسه. Now I'm coming to the most important part of this khutbah. Because I'm not going to accept many people coming for ruqya. Prophet ﷺ said, أو العلماء, he said that the best type of ruqya when you do it in yourself. Very simple. Get the authentic way for of ruqya and go pray Isha. How come I do ruqya while I don't pray? Yeah, it's يعني, you cannot, it's connected. You cannot take this away from this. You pray your Isha, you go to your bed, and you have the paper or the book, and you read it for yourself. You do ruqya for yourself. You do ruqya for your son. You do ruqya for your daughter. You do ruqya for your wife. You know, you dealt with this, but it's okay, do it, yeah. You do ruqya. You start practicing it. Practice it and do it with this yaqeen, as I started the khutbah with. And always have this ayah in front of your eyes. أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى قَالَ وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ
الظالمين إلا خسارة. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلنا جميعا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، كفر عنا سيئاتنا، توفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وأعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين. انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في شتى مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم ثبت على الحق أقدامهم، انصرهم يا رب على عدوك وأعدائهم. تقبل يا رب دعاءنا لهم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأطيب الصلاة.